Let's say you have a garden. You go out of town, things happen. Weeds grow. You might come back and say, "Hey, where are my pepper plants?" And you might feel defeated as a gardener. But don't despair. Sure, that's a lot of weeds, but that's a lot of great food, too. How is that possible? Well, that's red root pigweed, Amaranthus retroflexus. They are a bane to farmers, but a boon to a gardener who can recognize them as food to harvest rather than weeds to dread. So if you would rather see your garden weeds as an opportunity rather than a problem, watch this video all the way through and get to know the red root pigweed. And if you have friends that suffer with these weeds, share this video with them. I think they'll appreciate it. Welcome to Haphazard Homestead. I'm Holly Chris. I'm glad you're here. There are so many weeds worth getting to know. But before I pull all those weeds in my pepper patch, I want to show you a red root pigweed up close. This one was growing more out in the open, so you can see it a little better. You can sure see how it gets the name of the red root pigweed. Look at that red root.
It grows in a really interesting way. It's not completely alternate, but it goes around the stem. First this side, then that side, then that side. From the top, it looks like they're growing two across from each other, two across from each other, two across from each other. You can see the leaf here has a long stem right there, and then it has a center rib, and the veins come off not opposite each other, but alternate from each other. Prominent ridging. Take a look at that. Sometimes this is a little red on the back, and then the boundary of the leaves, it's not serrated. It has a stout stem, flexible. More branches coming out from the axle, just like a tomato, but they're not related to a tomato. But it's the same way that a tomato grows. And if you have a little one, it's just the same thing, only in miniature.
If you think of amaranth as weeds, it can be so intimidating to pick them all. But if you think of them like a spinach that planted itself, it's easier to keep a positive attitude. It's a completely free harvest. It's amazing to think about how many amaranth seeds there are in this soil. The seeds that sprouted and became these plants are mostly just in the top half inch or so of the soil. After the ground gets disturbed, like from rototilling, amaranth seeds sprout quicker than most other summer weeds. But then they go one step further. The amaranth seedlings stretch out and grow tall really fast too. So they can overwhelm garden crops that are planted from seed. They aren't so hard on transplants like these peppers. But it was a good thing that I got home when I did. They would have outgrown the peppers in another week or so. But being all crowded like this and growing so fast, there is one nice advantage. If you've watched many of my other foraging videos, you know that I stress that it's important to pick clean and pick organized. So what's nice is that the red root pigweed can outcompete almost all the other weeds. This is almost a solid stand of amaranth. Once I get a nice handful of pigweed plants, I cut their roots off and I leave them in the garden, like a chop and drop. Those roots don't sprout again, they just put nutrients back into the soil. Having a good crop of amaranth shows that the soil does have a good supply of nutrients, like nitrogen and readily available phosphorus and potassium. When the red root pigweed grows thick like this, the harvest goes pretty quick. I don't bother to pull the weeds that are just starting to sprout under the amaranth. I can cover them with mulch later. But if I see lamb's quarter like here, I leave that. Lamb's quarter is as good to eat as anything I could possibly plant. I've got other videos about lamb's quarter that I'll link to at the end of this video. So how much red root pigweed was there? Yeah, well, this bowl, sure. And this box. This box is packed tight with amaranth greens. That is a lot of free greens that took no more work than picking it. And then, just before sunset, I finished with this box of amaranth greens. That box is packed tight, too. Altogether, it was over 15 pounds of red root pigweed. Just look at all those red root pigweed roots. That was a lot of weeds, but that's going to make a lot of good eating too. What would you do with all this harvest? Let me know in the comments below. I'm going to take these to the kitchen and show you how to get the most food out of all these great weeds. I wash all the greens and then sort them out into different sizes. And you may say, hey, why do you do that? It's because these are weeds. Sorting them out forces me to look at each plant. I tried to pick clean, but it's important to make sure that I don't have other kinds of plants that nobody should eat. And I take out any poor quality plants too. Another reason that I sort my pigweed plants is that some have a more stout stem. These stems are still supple and tender, and they would cook down just fine with the greens in something like a soup. That way, I can make a whole different kind of food out of the stalks. I can make pickles or fermented stalks, or use them chopped up in a casserole. If you like using amaranth stalks, I'd like to know what you do with them too. Let me know in the comments below. Harvesting so much red-rued pigweed at once, I could feed a big crowd by making a big pot of greens and ham hocks. I've got a video on how to make that using some other springtime garden weeds. You can check that out up in the card up in the corner. But amaranth greens are so easy to freeze. Why? Because they are not bitter. I can use the same cooking water to blanch the greens over and over again. I couldn't do that with dandelion greens. Freezing greens is so easy. First, they get a quick 2-minute dip in boiling water, and then a quick rinse in cold water to stop the cooking. Once they're drained, they get bagged up for the freezer. It's such a shame to get bummed out or overwhelmed in the garden by edible weeds like the red root pigweed. I ended up with 17 quarts of wonderful garden greens without having to plant anything. And I still got a good crop of peppers too. I hope things are going well at your place, and may all your garden weeds be as tasty as the red root pigweed. Thanks for watching. Bye.